Okay, so look, what I thought we'd do is I just want to make a few comments on swine flu. I'm going to pass over to Tony to make some comments as well. Then once we've finished that, we'll go back through all of the other issues that no doubt you want to discuss. So, first, in terms of the update, I mean, obviously there is a high level of community concern about the implications and risks of swine flu. The government is doing its best to make sure that people are fully informed. There's been regular press conferences, as I'm sure you're aware, and we're doing whatever we can to contain this situation. On that note, I'll pass over to Tony for the latest, and we'll take some questions on that, and then, as I say, we'll come back on all the other issues.
Tony. Thank you, Prime Minister. As you know, we are endeavouring to keep everyone informed as we're going along with the latest information. This is the case information at 2 o'clock today. We've got 86 confirmed cases of swine flu in New Zealand. That's up 15 on yesterday, and that number is expected to rise further today as more information comes in. What we're seeing around the world is that there's a rapid transfer in young people, and we know from overseas that it's more severe for those who have underlying health problems. The Ministry of Health is stepping up its information campaigns about flu prevention this week. The government strategy remains containment, where we're wanting to delay the major impact of the swine flu on people and the community beyond the usual winter flu cycle if we can, as it might be mild for most people, severe for some, but very contagious because we have no immunity. And that is why the government's endeavouring with the health authorities to delay the spread. Normally we'd probably see about 31,000 medical admissions a month into our hospitals during the winter season. Officials think that we could end up with another 4,000 or so if the swine flu peak matches the winter peak, and that is why we're working assiduously to try and prevent that from happening. So the public health messages remain the same. People who are feeling unwell should ring their doctor or health line. If you've got the flu, you should stay at home or away from work. But any inquiries, people should be in touch with their doctor or health line.
Questions?
Yes, that's a very good point. We have stepped up the radio advertising in the last week. There are a number of billboards going up specifically around the international airports. There's been some newspaper advertising over the last week, and the Ministry of Health has today decided to further step up the advertising and information campaign, mainly around the helping not to spread the flu message.
Is there any sort of modelling or estimate on how many people might be out there now with swine flu but don't know it?
We don't have that information. We haven't got any evidence of sustained community spread as yet. As you know, we've got a number of cases in Wellington, Auckland, and one other location. What we do know, though, if you compare us with Australia, we have, on a proportionate basis, a quarter of the spread that they have in Australia. So the containment measures we've taken to date are proving successful in delaying the wide community spread of swine flu.
Minister, what would you say? We've got a school we're taking in Auckland. Now we've got another school in Arriwa who have
Yeah. Look, I think schools should be in touch with their public health authorities whenever they want to consider any actions like that. There are protocols in place that are being followed, and schools would be best to talk to their local public health unit rather than take any decision on that. Well, look, I don't know the circumstances behind it. They'd be best to talk to their public health unit. I'm not informed on that case. What I am getting some information about is that there may be a couple of other classroom closures expected this afternoon as well, and information will come from the Ministry if that's available.
Is there any plan to lower the control levels on access to Tamiflu as this develops?
Look, as it develops, we'll be reviewing all our plans with respect to the way that we prevent this. But you can be assured that the focus is really on protecting people. And so you'll see from the health authorities, if they decide to change the way that we access Tamiflu, we'll inform you of that and give you the reasons for it. The real focus, though, is protecting people with that use.
There's no plan,
John. There's no plan currently to change that use today.
Any thought about advancing the start date to school holidays or prolonging the school holidays?
No. Well, that's an important message, is that for many New Zealanders, they will be able to care for themselves at home with this flu, because it'll be, for most New Zealanders, it will be mild, but it will be severe for some. And for most of those with mild symptoms and mild flu, they'll be at home looking after themselves. Certainly the World Health Organization says that most people recover at home without medication. But what we know is that there will be some severe cases, and that is why the health system is there to protect those people as much as we can.
Have you had any advice about the potential for medium term, a second wave, more serious form of
Yes, certainly there is a view that there could be a second wave of a more serious case, and of course we don't know what this flu may or may not turn into if there is a second wave. So that is being factored into our planning, but at this stage we're very much focused on containment and getting the advent of swine flu further in New Zealand beyond the peak of the normal winter seasonal flu. Because if we can delay that, it means not only have we got less pressure on our workplaces and our schools, but importantly on our health services. So the government's maintaining this containment policy because it has helped us get to the position where on a proportionate basis we've got a quarter of the spread of Australia. But look, increase in numbers is inevitable, community spread is inevitable, but authorities are doing their best to delay this as long as possible.
Isn't it the fact that many more people are killed by the common garden variety flu than would have been killed by swine flu? And, you know, some people may say we're having a total overreaction to all of this.
Look, I think what makes it different here is that this swine flu is novel to New Zealand and we don't have immunity. So there are going to be larger numbers of people getting this flu, and that means there will be larger numbers of people who are sick and larger numbers who may have a severe form of flu. What we are trying to do is to delay the swine flu in New Zealand as much as possible past the winter seasonal flu peak so that our services are able to deal with that best. But as I say, look, for most people it will be mild, but some people will have severe symptoms and the system will be there to protect them. Okay. There'll be a further update from the Ministry later this afternoon with that other information. Thank you.